se u Metkoviću na Neretvi 28. veljače godine 1915. za vrijeme Prvog svjetskog rata. Djetinjstvo i osnovnu školu svršio sam u rodnom mjestu. U gimnaziju sam otišao u Travnik, ti sretni dani kod otaca Isusovaca. Maturu sam položio godine 1933. Nakon toga odlazim u Zagreb, u Jordanovac, ulazim u novicijat Družbe Isusove. Filozofiju sam svršio u Italiji. Iz Italije dolazim ovamo u Indiju 30. listopada godine 1938. Jednu godinu sam proveo učeći jezike, nakon toga jednu godinu u Bošontiju pomažući oca Vizjaka. Slijedi bogoslovija na Himalaji u Korsongu, gdje sam bio zaređen 21. studenog 1943. Bilo mi je tada 11 godina. Zakasnivši na parobroz za Split, dva mlada Isusovca morala su prenoćiti u mom rodnom mjestu Metkoviću. Oduševio sam se za Isusovce, otišao u malo sjemenište u Travnik. I tu, u malom sjemeništu, sastao sam se s pravim misionarima, s misionarima s bratom. Magister Josip Vizjak i brat Mijo Schmidt pred polazak u Indiju došli su na oproštaj. Upitali su nas tko će u misije i magister Josip Vizjak uprije prstom na mene i reče: mali, hoćeš li ti? I ja sam mu rekao hoću i riječ sam održao.
Krenuo je 20. listopada 1938. tada najmodernijim parobrodom, Viktorija, to vidimo na slikama. I nakon, koliko je trajalo putovanje, nekih, ne znam, 3 mjeseca mislim da spominje, i opisuje on to putovanje u svojim pismima, sve imamo dokumentirano, što je sve doživio, koga je sve susreo. I kad je došao konačno u Bombej, tamo u Bombeju su se iskrcali, onda su vlakom išli do Kalkute, to je veliki put. 20. listopada 1938. je isplovio iz Genove i 50 godina kasnije, točno na taj dan, je umro.
You know, this is the wild river practically. Along the river you see all this jungle practically. Today we could see some people are living over there. And Father Gabrik was working, hardly people were settled and they're living practically. Very, very few families, and it's all developed at present. There is no built bridge as such those days to cross the river or going to the boat as such. And Father Gabrik used to take a small tiny boat, so used to cross this river straightly and goes to Goshaba village and started the mission. Then there was nothing. We got no bridges, no good roads. Even this road was with the mud, you know. Even cycle rickshaws get stuck on the road because the mud is very silky with water just gushing out quite often, you know, saline areas. But as such, he never bothered about anything as such. Whether it's saline or rain or winter or cold or hot, nothing. Nothing bothered him. He takes the cycle by carrying the cycle to the boat. As he reaches back, take the cycle in the shoulder again, and he takes back. Everyone feels he's at home. And he also feels at home. We also feel that we are at home with him. He sits on the floor comfortably. I cannot squat actually. He can squat comfortably, and he can preach for 2-3 hours. He can preach no problem, tirelessly. But then, you know, he used to carry small sweets for the children. No, wherever he goes, he would take actually. That's if Papa is coming, Papa would bring something.
Kumrohal je smješten u delti Gangesa i okružen je silnim kanalima, rukavcima rijeka. Stalno kud god idete, cesta staje, moraš preko vode. Ali on je to sve obilazio na biciklu i naravno onda kad bicikl nije mogao dalje, on preko rijeke, on ga je uprtio na leđa i nosi preko te vode. I to su kilometri i kilometri prostranstava koje je on svakodnevno obilazio. Obično bi krenuo već u nedjelju poslije podne, jer ujutro je imao misu u Kumrohaliju, onda bi išao u susjedno selo, pa bi valjda tamo misu imao, pa s ljudima razgovarao, liječio uz put ljude, jer uvijek je nosio torbu s lijekovima, nosio je nešto jela koje bi podijelio sirotinji, a sam nije imao što za jest, spavao bi pod nekim drvetom, eventualno bi ga neko primio na spavanje. I tako je išao čitav tjedan po tom teritoriju, opet do kraja tjedna, pa se vraća u Kumrohali. I bio je poznat po tome što je neumorno hodao okolo i obilazio, ma makar je onu jednu dušu tamo na 100 km udaljenosti, njemu to nije bilo teško.
Gabriel worked in our diocese for about 37 years, and I had met him for the first time in 1968. I saw him going from village to village, walking miles and miles together, and at the same time visiting the people, comforting them, helping them, bringing in social developmental programs to the people and uplifting their material life as well as their spiritual life.
You know, when he came first to Mariapalli, he lived in a small hut and he started the mission from there. And he started the small church in the village, that side. Then slowly, when the community developed, he started making this church, and he lived a very simple life. With a cycle, he goes around with a broken back, and a deep, knee-foot deep mud, he walked around and spread the mission, spread the gospel values. He became very small for everyone, but he never allowed others to be small. As a poor life he lived, you know, for the sake of the poor, lived poorly in a very simple way with the 2 pants or 3 pants, and that's all.
Kaže, pitaju me zašto se malo finije ne oblačim. A ja im kažem, gledajte, ja sam jednostavan čovjek, a osim toga, evo neki dan, kaže, dok sam okliznuo sam se na nasip, upao sam u blato koliko sam dug i širok. I onda sam došao u selo, dječica su oko mene skakutali i smijali su se svi, naravno, znali su da sam to ja, ali bio sam pun blata.
Njega su volili svi, njega su volili djeca i odrasli, i bogati, i siromašni, i ateisti, i svi su ga voljeli. Tamo u selu gdje smo ga mi sreli, Tamo je imao i on jednog svoga gurua koji je navodno imao 116 godina. On je jako dobro mišljenje imao o ocu Anti. On je njega poštivao isto kao nekog našeg kršćanskog gurua. Tako se on odnosio prema ocu Anti jer je vidio da je to duhovan čovjek, da on meditira, da on moli, da on nije neki obični mešetar koji samo nešto trči, radi, vodi i tako dalje. S tim što guruji ništa ne rade. A otac Ante i osnivao i škole i tkaonice i poljoprivredu je učio ljude kako se sije, ne znam, kako se paradajz kvalitetan dobije, kako se paprika dobra dobije, kako se povrće bilo koje. Oni to nisu znali, oni to njih sve učili. U tom dijelu Delte Gangesa, to je vjerojatno najplodnija zemlja na kugli zemaljskoj. I zato je najnapučenija. Ona, to je džungla, a u džungli ima po kvadratnom kilometru najviše stanovnika na svijetu. Jer oni tamo kad dođete u rodno doba, to samo curi iz grana, banane, različito voće, to je rodno, riža tamo, oni imaju više puta godišnje žetu. To je doista plodna zemlja, a unatoč toga je to sve okolo džungla. Jer njih ima puno, oni svi gladni. Teško je preživjeti tamo.
On je donio, osim tih novosti zapadnog svijeta, i nekakve stvari iz domovine. Kako je odrasao, rodio se i odrasao na Neretvi, tako imao iskustva sa otkidanjem zemlje od mora, od rijeke. I prvi je počeo dole pregrađivati kanale i radeći nasipe oduzimati moru komade teritorija. Kasnije je nasipao ta područja i stvarao plodnu zemlju. To je naravno proces koji traje godinama, ali tako je povećavao mogućnosti ljudima da imaju na čemu raditi i gdje živjeti. Kasnije i država to počela raditi kad su vidjeli s kojim uspjehom on to radi. Znači stvarao je nova područja, jer glavni problem tamo što ljudi imaju male parcele pa ne može dovoljno hrane si ni proizvesti za samog sebe, a kamoli da nešto proda. Znači bitno je imati neku zemlju.
Pa mnoga sela on sam kompletno izgradio, znate, jer kad je jedna obitelj sa puno djece, oni moraju još puno kuća napraviti, kad se odraste, žene se moraju puno kuća, tako da je puno novih sela on podigao, kompletno nova sela, cijela nova naselja podigao. Ali to ne zbog toga da bi bio graditelj, nego zbog toga da imaju gdje ljudi krov na glavu.
Radio isto tako i puteve, ceste, postavljao je pumpe, jer je vidio problem sa prljavom vodom i dan danas te pumpe funkcioniraju, stoje. Cesta je gradio od cigle, nije bilo ove tehnologije moderne, nego su slagali cigle i blatom lijepili, betonirali to na neki način i tih cesta još uvijek ima po tim krajevima. Ne?
Kad je počeo kao misionar, on isto imao jednu viziju što možda tek Papa Franjo sada provodi. On je bio ispred čak naše crkvene politike i teologije. On kad bi došao u selo, nije on njima rekao šta se klanjate Boži cikali, šta se šiva, ne znam, nija i sve ta božanstva. Ne. On je njima rekao, da, to je sve vi što vjerujete, sve je to u redu, ali vi nešto ne znate još što je najnovije. Nakon i Bude, nakon svih toga, došao Isus Krist na zemlju. I onda on njima, njima je bila velika, kako bi rekao, sablazna da Bog na križu visi, da je Bog umire. Njihovi su svi bogovi strašni, imaju puno ruku, puno nogu, puno glava, razumijete, imaju zmije oko, oni su strahota i trepe. A naš Bog na križu umire. E, ali onda njima pokazao šta je to ljubav, šta je to požrtvovnost, šta je to darivanje. Onda su oni vidi da on daruje, da onda drugi isto daruje jednim drugima i tako se širila ta kršćanska zajednica kompletno iz ničega. Jer on je došao na ništa.
Hello.
are so many good things and bad things happens in one's life. You know, we say so many things about Father Gabri, very high of him. And he has also difficulties in preaching the mission. Because everywhere his missions are not accepted. Once he was going to Ranigod, and a man comes and tells him, "You are tired, come to my place, I'll have some water and go." He laced with poison and sent off Father Gabri. Father Gabri drank that poisoned water, went back to the mission, said mass, and came back very joyfully. He was surprised to see Father Gabri back alive. He said, "Father Gabri, you are still alive." Then he confessed to him, "Father, I put the poison and gave you, and you know, God has kept you back again to see him. And he became a Catholic afterwards.
Prvo vrijeme imao otpor i muslimana i hinduista, jer normalno nova vjera dolazi, oni su se branili rukama i nogama, podmetali su mu i bombe, napadali su ga. Oni to sve stoički podnašao i svojim radom je mijenjao tu sliku u njihovim očima. Ne? I polako su ljudi dolazili.
Father Gabri was in Basandi. He was a small boy, little boy in the school, and everyone was observing Father Gabri because everything he knew, what he was doing with the people. Many places he made small bought land, small colonies for the people to settle there and to live them peacefully. And wherever he goes, he takes the gospel and he lives with them, he shares the gospel, and he never made any division. Oh, he's a Hindu, he's a Muslim, or he's a Christian. Always his mind goes for the poor, underprivileged, where the people could not get education. He came forward to give education. That's why in Basandi he made the technical school, primary school. So that is the way Basandi came up very fast. Today we see the Catholics take the highest position in this belt because they are highly qualified.
Father Gabri was my spiritual director. He baptized me and he helped me to come up in life. And thereafter I worked with Mother Teresa in the slums of Calcutta. Somehow I got some call from inside that I should come back to my native village and do something for the people, what Father Gabri wanted to do. Now we have 350 children. At the beginning we started English medium school, but we found that English medium school will not be appropriated in this rural area where the parents cannot give any guidance to them. So we have switched over to Bengali medium. But our English standard of English we have kept parallel to the first language, Bengali. We have also vocational training for the youth, computer training, job oriented computer training. And we have also training, sewing training, tailoring and embroidery training we give to the village ladies. Those who haven't been to school for higher education, and after taking training from here, many of these ladies have found place to earn their daily bread and make the family better off economically.
On imao svoje radionice, osnivao radne, recimo, tkaonice. Napravio bi po 40 ili 50 stanova i tu su djeca učila tkati, tkali su i to su prodavali. I tako su zapravo razvijali jedno gospodarstvo, jednu industriju. Nije samo bila milost nekakva. Nije on samo dijelio pomoć nekakvu koju dobio možda iz Hrvatske od nekuda.
He wanted to have education for all the children and he did that. Those children who cannot go out to the school because of the distance of the island, he brought the children to his place. He built up boarding schools, hostels, and he fed them there, educated them, gave them life formation, orientation.
Školovo ih je za šnajdere i za stolare, ali ne samo što ih je školovo, nego im je poslije školovanja i davao taj alat, jer bilo je bitno da on ima s čim poslije raditi. A problem s tim ljudima dole što ih je trebalo naučiti uopće raditi. Oni nisu imali to razvijeno, kako je situacija tamo kakva je, eventualno su nešto na zemlji, ako su imali zemlje kopali, drugih mogućnosti nisu imali. Ne?
Veliki problem te njihove tisućljetne tradicije, prvo je raslojenost po kastama. Iza njega je bio jedan šok veliki, jedan shvatio da onaj besprizorni, onaj iz najniže kaste, on ne želi, njemu je uvreda da njega kažu ili ćeš u višu kastu. To mi imamo krivu predodžbu, oni ne žele ići u višu kastu. Jer oni su uvjereni da oni imaju karmu i da su rođeni da budu u toj kasti. I sve što bi izašlo iz toga, oni bi povrijedili svoje poslanje, svoje, mislim, smisao svoga zašto žive na zemlji.
Ovo je zemlja hramova, zemlja milijuna božanstava, Kali, Durge, Krišno i Višne. Zemlja daleka, tuđa, misteriozna za mnoge, no za mene Indija. Moja Indija, moja druga domovina. Iza hrvatskog mi roda, najdraži narod na svijetu. Narod željan Boga. Narod željan vječnoga. Narod tako gostoljubiv.
Kad dođete u Indiju, ako ste bili na Neretvi, rečete, pa to je to. To je to. Čak su i Mičamci slični. I komarci, i šaš onaj koji niče, i ta voda mutna koja je okolo, taj miris blata, mokre zemlje, taj miris je isti, nema. I tu je on se osjećao tamo kao kod kuće. On je živio između i muslimana i hindusa. Hindusi ne jedu govedinu, muslimani ne jedu svinjetinu. I on nije jeo ni govedinu i nije jeo svinjetinu, to su oni svi znali da on to ne jeo. Jeo je povrće i piliće, ne. To je jeo i ribu.
He was not a priest only for the Christians or Catholics. He used to go to every houses, even the Muslims, even the Hindus, and regularly he used to visit the families. My father was a catechist. He used to work with Father Gavrik, and he used to go to different places crossing the rivers. In those days, he started here vocational training, then Bata Company. By his intervention, many boys and girls established themselves in the future.
He brought from the Trot Company, Bata Company, and he used to give them pair by pair. He would choose, and he would all the people have shoes because of him.
He used to teach and he used to show how people should live in cleanliness. Market was so dirty. One day, Father Gavrik took a broom and started to sweep. And the schoolmaster saw Father is sweeping, so they came to Father and took the broom from Father Gavrik, and they started to clean the market. And since then, that market is clean. People themselves, they try to keep it clean. They learn from Father Gavrik.
It's a Basanti mission, Basanti parish, where Father Gavrik lived for nearly 18 years, 18 long years in three different times. One time he wanted to make a grotto, he made a grotto here only in this very spot. And this Our Lady, which is in the top, he brought from Croatia by himself.
Svagdje gradio crkve, kapele, na nekim mjestima su to vrlo jednostavne male blatne kućice koje Ganges zna i naplavit odnjet, ali u ovim većim mjestima je gradio i prave crkve kao ovu Kumrohaliju ili Marijapoliju, kako je on nazvao taj centar svoj. I interesantno je da su i naši pomorci sudjelovali u tome, dopremali su mu cement iz Solina i na to je bio posebno ponosan da je ugrađen i dio Hrvatske u te crkve.
Paris was dedicated to Mother Mary by Father Gavrik and Mother Teresa. And I'm very proud to be the parish priest over this parish because the person who baptized me was the person who established this parish. I found that people love him so much. Though 25 years ago he has left this world, but still the people kept him in their heart. If you go to the families to visit, you will see practically in every house there is a portrait of Father Gavrik. Whether Father Gavrik is canonized by the church or not, but he is not only in our families, but also in our hearts. Every day we pray so that he should be canonized. And many people, when I go to the village, I hear from the people of our religion as well as from the Muslims and Hindus, they say, yes, Father Gavrik was a man of God. He used to pray. And by his blessing, we get a lot of facilities and favor from the God.
She is of Hindu religion. She underwent an operation on appendicitis, and the doctor assured her within a week she would be totally healed. But nothing happened. Only pus and blood was oozing out every day, and morning till night she used to cry. So days went on, and many people told her about Father Gavrik, holy man in this area. So she went to the grave of Father Gavrik, and she had been praying to Father Gavrik. During sleep, she had a dream that she was called by a lady sent by Father Gavrik that he wanted to meet her. So the lady takes her, and she was taken to a deeper level. It's a beautiful place. where an old man was sitting, and he blessed her and put a hand everywhere and touched her, and she cried and told, because the people are saying, I may have cancer, I may die with cancer. He said, nothing will happen to you, you'll be totally all right, you go, I am with you. And since she came back, after slowly, slowly the blood stopped, the pus stopped and started drying up. She was very sure of the healing that Father Gabriel gave her.
My marriage was the last marriage by Father Gavrik. We have so much faith on Father Gavrik. My daughter was very, very sick last 3 years before, and we prayed to Father Gavrik, again and again prayed, and Father Gavrik cured her. Then last year I had an accident, and it was very serious accident. I had 6 stitched on my head and also some pain on the neck. But again, I started to pray to Father Gavrik, and Father is always with us and with his blessing with us. He always blesses, and I have so much faith on Father Gavrik.
Otac Gavrić je spavao vrlo malo, nekih 3-3,5 sata, išao je kasno poslije ponoći, dugo se zadržavao u molitvi, najveći dio vremena po noći on je odgovarao svojim dobročiniteljima u razne krajeve svijeta. Dakle, puno je vremena trošio pišući, odgovarajući na pisma, i mi kada gledamo u ovaj arhiv, onda je to jedno iznenađujuće, oko 7000 pisama, rukom pisano, strojem pisano. Zanimljivo je vidjeti, na primjer, on je pisao na ono što mu se našlo nekako pri ruci. Na primjer, mu čovjek napiše pismo, a on njemu odgovara s druge strane, isto to pismo mu samo na poleđinu mu odgovori. Ono.
Da je on danas živ, on bi sigurno bio na svim društvenim ovim mrežama, i njegov blog bi bio najbrojniji valjda što postoji u crkvi bilo koje.
Noć je žrtvovao, praktički to su, ljudi su se svi čudili kako možeš, Ante, tako izdržati to, takav jedan ritam. Međutim, on je bio je čovjek molitve, bio je čovjek posta. On jednostavno kaže da je u postu nalazio snagu.
Otac Ante je imao doista karizmu, svetosti. I kad je majka Tereze, koja je bila u Kalkuti, a on je s njom često komunicirao upravo zbog toga jer su govorili hrvatski, jer su imali iste ideje. Kad je majka Tereza tražila od svojih poglavarica da one njoj dopuste da ona izađe iz samostana i da osnuje svoju družbu, što je njezina poglavarica bila mudra pa je dopustila, otac Ante je tako tražio da bi on izašao isto iz svoje družbe onog okvira, da ostane Isusovac, ali da osnuje svoju družbu isto za gubavce i za siromahe. Njemu njegovi poglavari to nisu dopustili. Ali je veza između njega i majke Terese bila trajna.
Aha, Đorko Tefel. Aha, you see, that's a small house, Michael, they wanted, you see? These are small houses and you can see it. This is all veranda, eh?
How much does it cost this?
A big house like this, fully, it will cost more than close to 2,000 rupees.
2,000?
Bamboo is mandarin. Bamboo is expensive. Formerly, bamboo used to be cheap.
Gdje god je on bio, tu su prvo dolazile sestre majke Terezije i tu su liječile bolesnike koji su dolazili možda čak dan hoda, dva dana hoda, da bi došli kod njih po nekakve tabletice, da im se previju rane. Ako su gubavci bili, da se njima to, da se postavi dijagnoza, da se eventualno pošalju u grad gubavaca da se tamo liječe, ili da se, ako nisu zarazni, da se zaliječe u ovom svom mjestu, u svome selu. Tako da je ta veza, ta karizma jednostavno zajednička bila.
Plovili smo mi s Gabrićem po Gangisu, primijetio jednog ribara s ranom na nozi, na gležnju dole, i odmah je dijagnosticirao gubu. Ne? Kako on čitave dane ima noge u tom priljavom Gangesu, tako je došla guba i on je pokupio ranicu i to se onda inficira i krene guba. I odmah je reagirao, Poslao ga je u svoje selo, tamo sestre majke Terezije imaju stacionari. Napisao je pismo sestrama i odmah ga je poslao da ide, jer to se može zaliječiti da u toj mjeri ostane. Poslao je kasno kad ti počne otpadati ruke i noge.
I stayed back for in Calcutta region. I was close, staying very close to mother. I was with the baby, substress, the babies. No? So any babies to go for adoption or anything, each time I used to go to mother house to get mother's blessing before they go to the family. So when I came here only, I realized their mother and father, they were so close, you know. My father also went to the people, went to the interior of the village of the people. So mother also had the same desire to go to the people, you know, the dark holes of the poor. So they both had the same vision.
When I was thinking about Mother Teresa and Auntie Gabrielle, both of them were competing each other in their virtue for holiness. While they're taking the base on Matthew 25, when I was hungry, you gave me food. When I was naked, you gave me cloth. When I was shelterless on the road, you gave me a shelter, and so on. And there was a great attraction to Christianity in that area. Today, anybody is Christians because of Father Auntie Gabrielle today, that area.
Dobivao na tone robe pomoći iz Hrvatske koja tamo je bila oslobođena carine i tu je sudjelovala čitava Hrvatska kroz akcije koje je provodio Mali koncil animirajući djecu skupljanjem markica, slanjem priloga, slanjem robe. Majka Terezija i on su imali tu privilegiju da su mogli unijeti u zemlju gotovo sve.
Now we have all means to go. We have boats, the father went with his own cycle and went in the village. How now also we find difficult to go by rickshaw, to get down and how father that many years before, how he managed to go with the son. This really, he had a real love for Jesus, to give Jesus to the people.
Ovo je slika sa jednog vjenčanja u Kalkuti. Posebno je zbog toga jer ova djevojka, mladenka, je prva štićenica majke Terezije, a mladoženja je prvi štićenik oca Ante Gabrića. I na taj dan smo naletili, bilo je zakazano njihovo vjenčanje. I interesantno je to što nisu imali ništa obući, nego otvarajući pakete pomoći koje su stizali svakodnevno majci iz čitavog svijeta, su pronašli prvo mladenkinu vjenčanicu, zatim za njega odijelo i nakon nekog vremena su čak našli i prstenje da mogu obaviti eto u potpunosti ceremoniju vjenčanja. A on vam je bio dobri duh tamo kad bi on došao u Kalkutu, sjećam se tih susreta s majkom, oni su bili jako intimni, bliski, pa već i time što dolaze iz istog kraja svijeta, isti posao su radili, ne? Ali on je bio tako živahan i vesel čovjek, brzo je govorio, vrckavo. Tako da jedan put bi unio među te sestre veselje. Ono, to su jako lijepi susreti bili.
Vera je realizacija da ćeš je za sente. Saint is not only who makes miracles, but saint who can stand all this, you know, in these problems with a smile. And she did it. To be a saint, it's so simple, and it's so also difficult, because simplicity is very difficult. Eh? That's we are so artificial nowadays, we complicate our life and our, you know, relation to God and to man.
Oni su bili veće zvijezde od bilo kojih drugih ovih naših zvijezda estradnih koji su bile svaki dan na malom ekranu. Majka Terezina je bila u svijetu jako popularna, a kod nas njome i otac Ante. Jer kažemo, mi smo znali, svijet drugi nije mnogo znao o njemu, ne. Ali mi smo znali da je on zapravo isto radi što je majka Terezija. Ona imala sreću da je ona imala iza sebe, rekao bi, jednu veliku svjetsku javnost, jer je djelovala u Kalkuti i širila svoje sestre, jer je mogla to raditi, bila je autonomna, mogla je širiti svoje sestre okolo po cijelome svijetu. Otac Ante nije tako, on je djelovao samo tamo u Bengalu, u džungli, tamo među krokodilima, tigrovima i među sirotnjom tamo unutar riženih polja i divljih banana.
Tu kad su dolazili, bili su zvijezde, ljudi, vjernici, koji su išli u crkvu i su znali ko su oni. I vi jednostavno niste više njima mogli u tim situacijama, po tim našim crkvama, pristupiti koliko su ljudi njih, samo što ih ne bi samljeli u toj guži, u želji da ih dodirnu, da ih ovi blagoslove, da budu blizu njih.
U 38 godina što sam dole u Indiji, ni jedan dan nisam bio nesretan. Ljudski govoreći teško je, močvare, kroz vodu i blato valjajući, pješice nedjelom i 20 i 30 kilometara, posonuli smo. Nema tamo cipela, nema ni kruha, rižu jedemo i u podne i na večer kad je imamo. Nema ni toga svaki dan, ali mi smo sretni. Što nam daje sreću i nama misionarima i našim vjernicima? Daje nam vjera, daje nam molitva.
Ovo je Ante, ovo je majka, dvije sestre, a vamo, je li ovo tata?
Je, to je brat mu Niko, brat Niko, brat Ivo, brat Gavro, Ana, svi su oni tu
bili. To su svi,
ta familija najbliža, znači od dva brata, djeca.
Najveći događaj je bio kad prvi put došao. To je bio, kako bih rekla, to su bile suze, to su bile... Jednostavno čovjek nije mogao razgovarati, počne razgovarati, zapneti u grlu, ne može izgovoriti.
I bio je doživljaj, mislim. Uvijek smo čuli priču svećenike u Indiji, a nismo ga nikad vidjeli. Otac Ante je imao 4 sestre i 4 brata i on 5 bio. Najmlađi. Najmlađi je bio Srica Ante, tako? Srica Ante je bio najmlađi.
Gabro?
Gabro je bio najmlađi.
Gabro je najmlađi.
Onda je bilo dirljivo na groblju. Kad prvi put došao, on je na groblje donio što su njegovi vjernici ispravili vijenac voštani koji oni na grob svoji mrtvi stavljaju. I on je to položio majki na grob. Plako je. I to je nešto što, mislim, što nas je strašno dojmilo, jer za života nije vidio majku.
Naše obitelji su siromašni. Ali imaju djece, najmanje 5-6 djece u svakoj obitelji. Sjetio sam se onda svoje pokojne majke i ja sam bio 9. I da je moja majka, da se je stidila majčinstva, ne bi Ante danas tu bilo pred vama. O, molim vas, budite nam majke, spasite nam, naš narod. Svojom majčinskom ljubavlju, spasite nam domovinu, ne budimo sebični, ma žrtvujmo se, nemojmo se križa bojati. Bez križa, braćo, nema puta. Da je bilo drugog puta, Isus bi ga sigurno izabrao, ma sigurno.
When Father Gabri came here, he asked me, you are in the boarding convent and I love mothers and I want the mothers should do something here. I asked Father what you want me to do, then he told you gather some women. so that I can form the sorority. So I called 25 mothers and father called a meeting and made everything clear about the rules and regulation and the duties. And in those days, if somebody dies, nobody used to go there to pray. And it is the father who advised us that when somebody dies, you should go and pray in that house for that person. And in that way, father taught us a lot of things that we never knew.
Early morning, 20th of October, Father Gabrick called me, Father Sylvester, could you help me? Don't mind in this night, I am disturbing you. I am feeling heavy pain in my chest. I understood that maybe the last moment. I told him, Father, shall I give the last sacrament? I brought took the Holy Communion from the church. I gave him the sacrament. Then he asked me, Father, bless me. I blessed him the last blessing, and he was so happy. Every moment he was so humble. And he was so surrendered. As he was washing from the basin, he told me with a smile, big smile, I could feel that someone is standing this side of the bed. Father Sylvester, Jesus is calling and I should go.
On je htio ubriti u Indiji I biti tamo pokopan. On sa bočica mora I grudom neretvanske zemlje.